There is no unemployment in the kibbutz. Everyone works an eight-hour day. The young and the old work a few afternoons a week. So everyone plays their part in running the kibbutz and receives their share. And there's always some work for everybody. Each member can make a contribution no matter how small. He will not become redundant. The rewards and prizes of our society have no place here, which is perhaps why the kibbutz has no crime and no juvenile delinquency. It doesn't even have a policeman.
There's no crime in the kibbutz because everything is given to you by the kibbutz. You are part of it. You won't steal from yourself.
Living on the kibbutz, it's easy to forget that originally this land was owned by Arabs. But the reminder is not far away for those who care to look. 1 mile away is an Arab village, one of the poorest villages in Israel. Another world, and the two worlds rarely meet. Could the socialist kibbutzniks not do more to help their neighbors?
I have to admit that we don't do enough for them, although the difference between us is not a matter of ideology alone, but a matter of habits, of way of life, of tradition. 7 years ago, we had a group of Arab youngsters in this kibbutz that were trained in various branches, and we hoped, we thought that they might establish a kibbutz, an Arab kibbutz. The attempt didn't succeed.
The attempt failed because of a clash of cultures. One reason was religious. The Muslim faith did not allow young unmarried girls to live alongside boys in the close proximity of kibbutz life. Again, in the Arab home, the man is the undisputed master. Anyway, today there's little contact between the two neighbors and little help.
There is some problems of the too much togetherness, there's no doubt about it. Some people suffer from too much collective life. A man is judged totally. He is observed totally. And he is observed by his friends. In all aspects of life, he has no place to escape to or to be alone or to change his image. And for some people it's hard.
Well, there's one thing that I know I have a very difficult time in the kibbutz with, and I'm part of it, is the criticism. We live very much together and we criticize each other a lot, and it's difficult to be in the focus of everybody else so many hours a day, 24 hours a day, except when you're asleep. And sometimes I don't go to the dining room when I don't want to see so many people. I just have a meal at home. Not because I feel like making the meal usually, but because I'm tired. I don't want to see people.
From time to time, conflicts come to the surface, and perhaps a bad atmosphere is created temporarily. But because eventually, living in such a closed community, everything has to come to the surface, the thing blows itself out. And although we have these explosions once every so often and not so very often, it's perhaps not such a bad thing that this does occur, that we are brought into such close contact that conflicts are brought to the surface and get themselves aired. And afterwards, things cool down again.
The kibbutz does demand the highest ideals. Its members learn to put the common good before their own selfish interests. In Israel's three wars since 1948, the kibbutzniks have been to the fore in bravery and sacrifice. Yet perhaps the real conflict facing kibbutz life goes deeper than an occasional outburst of tension. The parents chose kibbutz life. The children know no other. If they stay, they play a full part in this tight-knit, almost insular society. But do all of them possess the same idealism that inspired their parents? How many will want to continue? The kibbutz was once the symbol of Israeli life. No longer. Israel is changing fast. But the kibbutz idea, a community where all are equal and money and possessions don't count, is spreading elsewhere. Will the kibbutz survive? Some have no doubts.
I believe that we shall have more and more people joining with us because we see that the outside world is now in a changing condition and people are looking for a solution. I don't know if we have the solution. I'm not sure. But anyhow, we try to have some solutions to life of the in the 20th century of a cultured man, of a man with values, of a man who thinks. And I believe that the kibbutz will change and adapt itself to the demands of the coming generations.